are you waiting for the lecture today?
Yes.
The lecture by Dr. Francesco Martin Bellantino. I think the most of the head of the mission know who is this gentle Professor Martin. Director of the Egyptology of the Complutense University of Madrid. Professor of Middle Egyptian in the Complutense University of Madrid. Faculty of Documentation and Ethnography. Professor of Ancient Egyptian History and Civilization. Cooperation with the Department of History of Malaga University. Director of Selenmut Project, TT353. I think everybody knows where the tomb of Selenmut, the one under Hatshepsut, not the other one. Director of the Vizier Ibn Qutb Hiwi Project, Assassin's Tomb, number 28, from 2009 until now. I hope that in this season or the next season, you will find more projects, more things, and for the next lecture, you will have more lecture from Dr. and Professor Martin, please.
Thank you so much for listening here. Yesterday, I would like to thank for this opportunity to address you, everyone here, the director of this museum, Mr. Mohamed Sakata, and our host and good friend, Mr. Mohamed Ibrahim, the former director of the Temple of Karnak. Also, I want to give a special thanks to all the staff of the Tafish, Mr. Paki Yassin. Everyone shall know I'm in Vitor's feedback. And because Egypt don't respect so much the academics meetings, and I am here because everything was ready to go, but in fact I shall be there. Anyway, thanks for everyone, all the colleagues, members of the mission, directors of institutions, friends, colleagues. Thanks so much. I will try to explain you today what about our project. Our project is really a very ambitious matter of work in archaeology because when we began, I suppose in general, nobody can understand or expect what we will find. And I can tell now, personally, that just as director, not because something belonging to me, I'm prouder, very prouder about the opportunity that the Egyptian authorities give us to work in this special and wonderful place. Really, thank you. The project began in 2009. Everybody knows this area. The place is very local. The place, you can see, or Fortland, is close to the castle way of the funerary temple of the Queen Hatshepsut, and immediately close also to the dome of Hebron. The main object of this project was the protection of the dome. And this project worked and cooperated a lot of people, a lot of institutions. Anyway, it is an initiative of the Instituto de Estudio del Antiguo Egipto de Madrid. Excuse me, sorry, one moment. Spanish Minister of Culture, in one of the seasons at least, the University of Malaga, currently, and the individuals with is to collaborate with the Egyptian authorities who are responsible in activities to obtain from time to time permission for investigation, presentation and protection of this town number 28 of Frederica Camp in Assasia. Well, we have here a plan of the town. This town had never been studied before, but was explored by Andrew Gordon and Wilhelm Einert in 1978. Its characteristics is have access corridor, open eye hotel, and a chapel. Clearly, the chapel is unfinished, and if it had been completed, it would have had a longitudinal hall, another room for representation of the deceased and his family, which are usually found in other similar towns. The chapel originally had three rows of enclosures, 13 in total, all in close proprietary style. Only two of them, seriously damaged, remain in place, while the other fragments were among the accumulation of debris, covering the floor of the chamber with other of several matters. This chapel is larger than that of the tomb of her wife, the steward of the great royal wife, Tiki 192. There is evidence of decoration of reliefs and painting designs on the central way, from the main entrance, exterior and interior walls, arriving to the unfinished door in the west wall of the chapel, and also in the ceiling. There are four columns with reliefs in squares E6, G6, and E7, G7. The other 26 columns have been partially sculpted in different stages, working from the central way toward the north and the south of the chapel respectively. Who was the receiver on a hotel room? Before all excavations works, we have very little information about the receiver. Now we can see, and before also, that the security, because Caminos and others, police talked about, he was the southern receiver on a hotel room from shortly before year 30 up to year 35. These pieces are found here in the town. The memory of the vizier, we had the possibility to check, was crucial. His depictions and his description were striking. For example, we can see here this broken relief, especially broken by the hands. It is one of the characteristics of the persecution in the imaginary of the vizier. Is in connection with the hands and with the head. For example, this is the first piece we found belonging probably to the door of the chapel with the face of the vizier broken by me. We have a drawing here to check how the persecution, the main cause for the destruction of the evidence of the vizier in the town, were made under the idea to destroy his face and his memory. We have other pieces belonging also to the reliefs in the chapel. We can see how the same system is still the same system of destruction with the eyes and the face. And even we can understand sometimes something in the middle of the curious iconoclastic ideas in this moment. I'm talking about the period of Mehotep III and Mehotep IV. The persecution of the decoration inside the chapel arrived to make some mistake. We can read here and see clearly the destruction. We can read here, Yomahi Herget, mean justify the front of the God Geb. But I think maybe they make confusion with the lack of Geb and the lack of Amon. For the reason they destroy maybe the situation. Well, now we will see the historical as you can see in the window. We have over the tomb of Jack, 399. And down this wonderful hall was in fact the tomb of the deceased. I'm not sure when we ask to the colleagues here and all the friends in the antique service to work in this area, and some of them, because we have close friendship, begin to think these people are crazy. What they want from here? Sand and stones? Nobody can. I remember how even the cafe in the area, when we asked to visit the area, he don't recognize the place. We shall search around until we all go down, issue about the place. Well, the door of the chapel and the panoramic view inside in the season 2009. You can imagine looking this. What about? This is the level of the dream. It's like a sap, in fact. And this also shows the situation inside the chapel. The feeling was a lot, but it shows this is a special piece. When we see this, we talk about the Pachelet between us, from the girls, in a colloquial way. Is clearly as a feminine figure, maybe a concubine, in ivory, from all studies, can belong to the third intermediate, later on the side of the third intermediate phase, really all the piece from Amundsen. This was the situation inside the chapel. Imagine. In this moment, we can touch the capital by the hand. This happened in 2010. From all field rings, we have the evidences that after the Abraham period, this tomb was used during the late Ramesside period, third intermediate and late period, as a bed for the preparation of mummies, and also as a burial place for members of the clergy of Amun-Re. For example, we found on the excavation many places like this. In fact, it's a bed of mummification. It's not normal to find information about this kind of activities, but fortunately we have many documentation about. We can see the wood decorated, and we can see the evidence of bandits and many the bags of Macron. And in fact, to improve this place was a place to elaborate mummies. Also, we have this document, very important from my area. This is a graffito in column, we will talk after, in column Amenhotep 31, and show us the god Osiris is worshipped by someone at the end of the graffito. The name Kabinah is a scribe of Amon, and in the middle, the figure destroyed represented Abyssinia. With no clear name. But in this place, and for the data, for the date of the period of the graffito, we can understand how in the later side and French day the people really think the Odyssey was a safe land. They arrived in the chapel to worship the societies across. The chapel, as told you, was used as the burial place for members of the high clergy of Amun during the third intermediate period. Like, for example, Padi Nihonsu, a new people, not known before, who was probably a relative of Nihonsu I. Padi Nihonsu. We know this because around, because this burial place was dismantled and destroyed and spoiled But we found this scholar, many pieces of this scholar, typical from the high priestess of the 21 and 22 dynasties in Thebes. And this was the people because talk about the reign of the king, and offering of the king of the Roman Church for Parliament. Second, Heberra, Sepetunica. Other very interesting thing was this knife for the mummification. It's pure silver. And probably belonging also to or personalized by the council. This talk clearly about the liberty of these people. Well, we arrive to the season 2010. Excuse me, sorry. We can see here how is the difference in the Curia. Yeah? From the beginning of the establishment till now, just 1 year, we discovered the entrance, the two windows, and big part of the pillar in the northern wall of the Curia, and well, the situation. Inside the chapel, we are still working. I still remember what about the first pictures. Remember now? It was full of people. Talking about the season 2013, the situation was like this. And we decided to work to fix all the excavations in the central way of the chapel, looking to the west, from east to west, just to recognize what about the situation. Here, within a really controversial question. The correlation between Amenhotep III and Amenhotep IV. An ecological dilemma, a long coexistence, I think, more than a true long correlation. This can be one of the possibilities to consider this matter. Our interpretation about from the authorities from this discovery is that there was a short correlation about 2 years. An accurate system of another 8 to 9 years, during which Nemaire was the living Aten and Amenhotep IV Akhenaten was the pharaoh. Well, the history began in November 4, 2013. I remember well in the morning. We were excavating inside the chapel, in the central area of the corridor, and suddenly we discovered this piece. Belonging to a shaft of Aqualung. I was in the front controlling the excavation, and when this happened, I can't remember now how I was in the shaft, because it's very strange to find the tattoos of the Zapatulera, Wangra, in Fetes. It's not a usual matter. For me, at least, I was so annoyed. Well, the excavation continued, and we found more pieces belonging to 4 columns. And the Hotel 1, in the square G7, this is the drawing. And the Hotel 41, square G6, the drawing. And the Hotel 32, square G7. And I'm hoping for 2 square pieces. Well, I reproduce here a nice diagram to what I made close to him, because this was my first drawing of belonging to my team to explain to everyone a few days after the discovery what about the disposition of the relics. We have here the central corridor of the chapel with the 4 columns looking to the unfinished door in the west part of the chapel. And Hotel 1, and Hotel 41, framed 1 to 1, from 1 to 1, and Hotel 32, and Hotel 42. The first column was talking about the something very You can pray this, you know, pray if you, who appears in the Chimshah, the Lord will do that, and the Father will bless you, you know, upper and lower, the river in my boat, the my river in the and so on. But the most important here is, the, is in the part of the scripture talking about he who appears in the Chimshah, who will come back. The second column, Amenhotep 3:2, in square P7, talk about Son Ra, he who carries the crown, Amenhotep Hekawase, the Lord of Hathor, who is over the mountain, king of Upper and Lower Egypt, Lord of the two lands, he who joins them, the Maire, the Lord of Osiris, etc. The column, Amenhotep 4:1, in front of Amenhotep 3:1, talk about to be Son of Ram. He is who unites the crowns of Re. Amenhotep Netzer Hekawase, greed in his lifetime, the Lord of Osiris, the Lord of Abydos, King of Upper and Lower Egypt, the ruler of the Sud in Karna, the Father of Rabo and Re, beloved of Amun. And finally, the Amenhotep, the column Amenhotep 4:2, in square pieces, talking about the titular day of the king with the, as the others, with the cartouche, talking to Sanora, one who is in peace over the mind. Amenhotep Netzer Hekawase, great. In his time, the Lord of Captor, who resides in, king of Upper Lower Egypt, Lord of the Rights, son of Amun, Nefarhetu Ram, Wendra. The Lord of Amun, Lord of the two lands, well, the main question, to do short this position, is we, if we study the four group of inscription, we can find some special details. In Amenhotep 3:1, this inscription, I have Chimshah. This for us was interpreted as the possibility to have an indirect day, and we'll explain. Talking about the first jubilee of Amenhotep III in the Jasper. This order, Amenhotep 4:1, talk about something very interesting this, from a point, a religious point of view. The possibility to consider Amenhotep 4 as beloved of the ruler of the Sud Karnak, Amun Ra, who resides in the sacred land. And Amenhotep 4:2 also is very spectacular description talking about Nefarhetep Ra-Wendra as son of Imon, the god Amun. The main question it says is this horizontal lines in the descriptions talking about who was the author, the responsible about these inscriptions with his meaning. And to don't have any doubt about the vizier order to describe this, talking about he was the direct responsible. This inscription was made under the control and the order of this. And this is good reason. You know, this is good reason to destroy the memory, to stop the war, and to execute the vizier. Then, no any other commentaries, except the case of this poem, are a representation of the names of the two kings, father and son, crowned at the same time with the two names of the royal protocol, son of Re and king of Upper and Lower Egypt, in the sub of several columns, in the same space, one following the other, in two rows. This inscription, I have spoken before. The column on Amenhotep 3:1 is very important. I call it. It's Sa-Ra Hai Hepzenzat, the son of Re, who appears in the glory of Chimshah. We shall arrive to the decoration of the heroic throne. There we will find the same writing, talking, no same, similar writing, talking about the same moment. When the king was over the Chimshah. This means if we have this description. In all colon, you can understand the both in the word and all colon are talking about the same moment. Little far away, everybody knows because it's very popular term, we have this the exact date. We have 37 months, as you know, day 27. It's the day when the king appeared. In this case, we have the fact that the protocol of two kings, as you know, upper and lower ages together, a chronology at this point, the 27th day of the second month of Shemu, in the 30th year of Nebuchadnezzar, he appears and appears the chapter of the tomb of Ishmael Nebuchadnezzar. In this case, were there two visions of the south at the same time? We have some evidences about, for example, in Solet. I shall clarify this to the, for example, the drawing of the information of Georgiani about the temple of Solet, and I thought that we probably chase at the same time a Roman from this region. Both of them ruling at the same time for at least 2 years, from year 29 to year 31. We can see here Amenhotep III and in front of him the two visions. If it is true, the name of Amenhotep is related. You can see here. In this case, from there are more, but from this archaeological evidence, we can agree about the idea to have two visions in the same moment. But the question is, do the seed of the south of the same king? No. From all the story and the studies we have with, Amenhotep B was the seed of the south of Amenhotep III. In the excavation also we found this corner of a wall with a very important inscription talking about the moment to do, talking, the tradition is to do his navigation of the beginning of the year in the Hershel. This inscription referring to the navigation they have said, obviously the face of Amenhotep III, clearly connected with the navigation inscription in the tomb of Kerouac, celebrated, of course, the 27th of the second month of Shemu, in the year 30 of Amenhotep III. Also, we have other indirect evidence about the suddenly stopped work in the tomb. Something happened when the people are still working normally and arise somebody or people and order to stop the work. And there are strong evidences about this fact. For example, this image of a bearer of offerings, very similar to Ramos, that we can find the same design. In this case, in black color, ready to sculpt the sculptor, we can check how the posterior part of the head was in the moment to be sculpted. You can see it in the top right now. But the upper part of the head just was in dry. This is the one proof about the moment this was started. In this case, we shall recognize Amenhotep Huri for the king. The pharaoh Amenhotep III, and Ramosen was visited in this case of Amenhotep IV. Nobody, until now, disputes this matter. But there are very, very other, very interesting questions. If we agree about the situation to recognize the two visions in the same moment, and even from a geographical looking about the decoration of the both tombs, we can recognize the more or less the same school or the same hand working in the words. In this case, we found something interesting. Did the same artist make the same mistakes? Where what description coincided and executed at the same moment? We have this in the chapel in the north exam of the Lord. And in Ramosen, we have more or less the same test. This part. Talking about this is from our area, even not my area, the fellow Davis, not Manda Garris Davis, now this is the publication of the poem of the Sierra Mose, was a mistake in this description. Shall be, must be, nude, no, no the other lecture. To talk about the word movements. But in the same line, in the same column, we can find also this other, talking about this suite, the double camera, The determinative in this case can't be the visitor K. And we have the same mistake in the bottom. We can understand from this written detail, more or less, the same people were working in the bottom with a few short time between them. This is more powerful than descriptions about the titulatio of the pharaoh. This is the current situation. Well, we think everybody knows me. This is my way. This discovery may represent, as we believe, a very solid evidence about the convergence between Amenhotep III and Amenhotep IV. As we are in the presence of inscription dated exactly at the beginning of the first Hepsed of Amenhotep III, in the year 30 of his reign. I was then located in the same place, sculpted at the same moment, with no archaeological evidence of later intervention in the decoration of the monument. I remember now, here, the horizontal lines in the four columns, talking about the order that we need. This means the idea to consider later. In the time of Amenhotep the Third, make two columns in Amenhotep the Fourth, only two is not possible. This is a reconstruction in 3D about the original design situation in the chapel. And also our project considered as essential part that the reconstruction and restoration of the chapel. For that reason, we began our program of columns in the season 2013, where we will complete from the evidence we have. We can see here, for example, in season 2014, other columns. And this was the main target of all reconstruction place. And still, we are working until now with the team of Mr. Amir Baldadi, Luis Ibidas and Mr. Mohamed Salem, the right Mohamed Salem, working in wonderful agricultural reconstruction. Well, the first question was to consider what about the style of the column, original style. For the evidence, we realized, thinking the dimensions with the help of Gerardo Rivio, the architect of this year, what about the style, cloth papyrus, and the dimensions, and anything. But this happened in 2014, okay? But this happened a few days ago, in the excavation. We discovered an ostracon with the original design of the columns made by the people belonging to this time. But this happened, Maris, 3 years after. If we do some mistake, imagine. But it was wonderful to discover we were in the right way. Well, the reconstruction continued in the season 2014. The column on Amenhotep III one, used with half south. You can see here Raj Mohamed Salem working. Because the object was not used to recover the ambience of the chapel, but also to protect the inscriptions. In this year 2014 also, we recommended a secondary font belonging to later, now I can say Greek or Roman period. And we documented, I repeat, and a few days ago also, we excavate We have a stability. We found, this is a sub, the chamber, we found, in fact, was full of debris, and the mummies, the square mummies, but nothing in fact, except that they were really very nice. We are discussing now is the portrait of Cleopatra VII. Looking for the discoveries, because it is the history of the excavation, in 2014, we discovered also an unfortunate dead man. Belonging to a, it was in the place of, close to the east wall, the exterior wall of the chapel, and belonging to a single family without name. Well, from the information of the professor Levitsky, he proposed to recognize in the type of the model of this coffin a special exemplar of the type of this coffin belonging to the last part of the 20th dynasty. And the beginning of the 20th. He told me there are not so much coffins like this. For this reason, was very important feeling from all. This is the moment when the Minister of Culture and the authorities arrived to open the coffin in official manner. Dr. Manu Kedanati. For singers, that in the 8th November 2015, we discovered all the intact mummies. Was founded in the southeast corner of the museum. And with evidence of stereo evidence about something was that very carefully covered by blocks of limestone in a special, way to be buried in the territory of the Meridian area. Use the excavation from the body. Really was impressive. The decoration informs us about the technology, etc., about the chronology. And we began to recognize a real place belonging to the 22 dynasty. We can see here the toe, or the toe coming out of the level. This was the moment of the discovery. And finally, we recognize, we investigate, and we recognize what the real place from our 22 dynasty. And after this, we researched, we discovered the name of the owner, and the tomb belonged to our priest, the scribe of the divine offerings of Amun-Re in Karna, and Khafre-Nkhonsu. Well, in this case, we arrived in 2016. About this question, and this picture belongs to the current system. It is not finished yet. We are still working, I hope, until middle of December. But you can see from the beginning of the picture, when it was full of debris and stone, and until a hole, how changed. This looking to the, from the south. We have discovered, I saw this picture is not so good, it's not so professional, but I think we are working now. It's been tried by me, but the most important is to show how we arrive in the bedrock. And the most important is to confirm what about, because we arrive in the bedrock, what about the historical belonging to one man, and this also is lateral on the upper part of the cylinder. There are covering of inscriptions talking not about the funerary expectations of this man, no. Talking about the worship of the Son of Christ, the God. For this, we talk about this solar stella of Pan. Here, today, with us, my close and good friend, Dr. Johnson. And as he knows, Dr. Tenen is a part of our team. He made the honor to belong to our team, and he's a professor and consultant in many topics like this. Quickly, I sent him the news and the picture, and I proposed my idea, and he told me, no. Can I tell? We don't know what it's for. For me, I was thinking, can be, because I wasn't afraid we can put this in the head, no, the 18th dynasty, but no, he told me, and I agreed, of course, what I can tell. Anyway, this great piece and proof, what about the original date of the Pope? And what happened in the Pope? I can explain now because we haven't time. Maybe Mr. Fatty, the next season I can make a good interpretation about all the program. Will be good. But the most important also, in the last moments of the operation, when nobody expects to find nothing, we found this little piece. Asymmetrical yard sitting, in translation, I suppose, then my ready the law of the food offerings of the northern, non kahasu. Well, I mean, this is everybody agree about its origins belonging to the delta, coming from the delta, from the north. But the most important is in the original level of excavation, with the evidences about the interruption of the war, somebody ordered to bring offering. Funerary, not funerary, but the food offering, to open the place of the place, and to make some ceremony, we don't know. We mix this with the four examples of pottery belonging to the Julian period of Amenhotep III, we can see some connection, but on the case, we have some doubt. Also, we found close to this pottery piece or clay piece, this other, Ayar's copper seal, maybe belonging to the same year with this. Then my reign is the Lord who commands the Hesed. In this case, we have many, many groups to talk clearly about the first Jubilee and all the results of meanings give us the opportunity to offer of idea about everything I told you before. Well, today also we want to use this opportunity to inform everyone about the publication of the preliminary memory of excavations belonging to the seasons 2009-2016. We can't wait more to offer all results to the scientific community. And this appeal to September 25 with us, and also is a great opportunity to inform about this in an official way to all our colleagues and specialists about this book, ready to consult in the library of the Chicago House. And now I would like to some 12 or 11 minutes more, because I want to close this conference, this lecture, without giving some reconnaissance or homage to the people who were working here for 9 years, 8 years. For
make everybody happy, really. This is very important. The restorer, the worker, the inspector. Really, what we saw today, something amazing. Thank you. Before we finish, before we ask Dr. Martin a question, I'd like to mention something because next Sunday, there is a lecture. I hope everybody here. By Dr. Campbell Price, Manchester Museum. And he talk about Egypt exploration society. Yes, this will be next Sunday, 7 the evening. Okay. If anyone have any questions, please for Doctor. Okay.
You talked about a period of co-regency followed by a period of coexistence. Have I got that correct?
Yeah. Google's now.
Well,
this is an idea, just idea to make a new interpretation about the period. Everybody knows was a long discussion about, because one of the main problems to understand the situation is how we can recognize or understand two kings with courts, with two army of functionaries, no. And this one of modules. But a student, and especially from the students and publication of Dr. Johnson, he was the beginning to talk about the new solar divinity, personality of Amenhotep III. And for me, this showed the way to recover a new interpretation. Just we need also to improve the existence of this period, this period. And in fact, we understand how, in fact, it's true from more or less, I believe, from 28 of Amenhotep III until the third jubilee, but the four kings were doomed together. For this reason, we have the proof of the two viziers. Okay, and this is more or less is in the frame of the chronological moment. But after this, Amenhotep III changed this whole idea. Changed his nature, arriving to be the living atom. And his high priest and the pharaoh as normal will be his son. This came without the normal situation in the history of Egypt. The king is the king, and the pharaoh is the pharaoh. But the both were living together from some time, because with this proof, I don't want to talk now because it's very long history. But you know, this is the idea. For this reason, I talk about two. Yes, of co-regency, short co-regency, and maybe 8, 9 more years or more of coexistence.
Anyone you want to ask Dr. Francesco? No, no. Thank you again, Doctor. And really, you make not only me, everyone. Really, thank you.